welcome to my channel or channel on literature with Simi Rachel. I'm really happy to see you all supporting me, and I'm very happy that most of you are commenting in my inboxes and giving me valuable suggestions for which I have to take and all. So keep on supporting me, keep on watching me. So today I'm here with a new topic and a new writer. So let's move on to today's session. Today I'm here with a writer, Geoffrey Chaucer. Geoffrey Chaucer was a writer of the 14th century. He was famous as a poet and as an author. He is known as the father of English literature and father of English poetry. So today we'll be dealing about Geoffrey Chaucer. Geoffrey Chaucer, he was a greatest writer in the 14th century. He was famous as also an author. He was the first person to be buried in Poets' Corner in Westminster Abbey. Poets' Corner is the resting place of the writers in English. And Geoffrey Chaucer was the first person to be buried in Poets' Corner of Westminster Abbey. Then Geoffrey Chaucer was a person who used to observe very keenly every minute things around him. And thus, his famous work or magnum opus or masterpiece work is none other than Canterbury Tales. Today, I'll be dealing with Canterbury Tales. Canterbury is the name of a place. And Tales, what is Tales? It's stories. Place name and stories. So, Canterbury Tales is a tale with, it's having 24 stories. All these things you have to keep it in your mind. The Canterbury Tales, it has 24 stories, 29 pilgrims with 17,000 lines. And the first 858 lines is the prologue. So Canterbury Tales, it's having 24 stories in it. It has 29 pilgrims. It has 17,000 lines. And prologue, it's from line 1 to 5, 858 lines carries prologue. Now, our Chaucer, he meets in a tabarden. In Southwark. Tabarden, you have to keep it in your mind. So, Chaucer, he goes to the Tabard Inn, and from there he sees 29 pilgrims. And in this Canterbury Tales is a masterpiece work of Chaucer, and Chaucer has presented these 29 pilgrims in a very beautiful way. He has presented what is there in that society, is really taken the society inside. You can see, especially he is acting as a critic of the church, and he detailedly describes the 29 pilgrims. And there in the tavern inn, he sees this 29 pilgrims, and these 29 pilgrims, they are now in London. From London they are going to Canterbury to see the shrine of Saint Thomas Becket. This thing also you have to keep it in your mind. Tabard Inn, and Saint Thomas Becket Shrine. Okay, Shrine of Saint Thomas Becket. These 29 pilgrims here going for the pilgrimage. And in that night time, all these people, all these 29 pilgrims, along with the Chaucer and a host is also there. Chaucer is there. Then one host is there. Name is Harry Bailey. And they meet in the Tabarin. And next morning, in the early morning, they have to set their journey, set out their journey to Canterbury. And how they going is, they going on the top of a horse, because it's 14th century, there's no vehicles. To reach 55 miles, they have to travel long, they cannot walk. So they are traveling in a horse, and they will start their journey in the early morning. And in the night time, all these 29 pilgrims along with Chaucer and our host Harry Bailey meets together. And in order to make their journey more happier, more enjoyable, what they does is, they'll tell that tomorrow morning, our host is telling, tomorrow morning I'll be giving some duties to make our journey more attractive or happier or enjoyable. So what happens in the early morning, they gather together for setting to their journey. At that time, this host tells that you have to do one thing. You have, through your journey, you have to tell two each stories. Means, while going, two stories, and by coming back, two stories. Okay, so, and the winner of this contest will be given a prize. And the prize is that a free meal will be given in this in Tabar, in from the Tabar Inn, the winner will be getting a free meal. Okay, that is the winner's prize. And 29 pilgrims, they start their journey. Next, our Chaucer. Here Chaucer is a narrator. Now Chaucer presents before us the 29 pilgrims in a very beautiful way. The first pilgrim in the Canterbury Tales is the knight. The knight is the first pilgrim. Knight is the most respectable person and the most prestigious person in this Canterbury Tales. All the other pilgrims, what they do is they respect this modest person. And this knight, he's very modest, he's very brave, courageous, honest, truth and everything. He is a step higher. And he have fought 15 battles. He have participated in 15 battles and also in the crusades. Also was a participant in the crusade. Moreover, he had killed three men. He had killed three men in Warfront. Okay. So these things comes in knight. And one more thing is that knight always wears a simple cloth. I told you, he's very simple, honest, loyal and all. So he's always wearing simple clothes. And in this Canterbury Tales, we'll see him in a simple cloth and his clothes are stained. And how it's stained is that he's wearing a chain on his chest. That chain is a cord which was given by the king to participate in the battle. And by wearing that chain, his clothes is fully changed. Means that he is coming to this tavern in to join the pilgrimage soon after a battle. So, these things are seen in the night. Now, next one we'll see is Squire. Next pilgrim is Squire. Squire is the son of knight. He's a young man of 20s. He's acting as an assistant of his father. He is also brave. He is also courageous. Moreover, he is well dressed. Well, colorful dress he wears. And what is there in his dresses? It's fully colored and flowers are embroidered in his dress. Green color, red color, every sort of colors are embroidered. Flowers are embroidered in his dress. Moreover, he is described as he's fresh as the month of May. Fresh as the month of May. Fresh as month of May. Keep these things in your mind, because all these things which I am telling in this underline can be asked in the NET exam. So, fresh as the, who, a question can come like this: who is described as a fresh as month of May in Canterbury Tales? It's a squire. Then this squire, he used to write poems, he used to sing well, and also he used to write, sing, and also draw beautiful pictures. So this is squire. He is also modest, he is also brave, he is also courage and very helpful to his father. And that is squire. And next we are going to see a yeoman. That is knights. Knights. Yeoman. So knight's yeoman, he is the servant of a knight. And in this Canterbury Tales, Chaucer presents him as a man wearing green color dress. From his head to toe, he is wearing a green color dress. Then he is having arrow and a bow in his hand always, and also a sword and a dagger. Means what he does is, he also always stand to protect a knight. Then his face is brown in color, and also he act as a Robin Hood. All these things is about knight's yeoman. This yeoman is only seen in the prologue. Prologue means the first part. Next we see the prioress. The prioress. Prioress. Prioress means what? Prioress, similar to our mother, superior, like that. So a nun. Nun, okay. A superior nun. A superior. This, you just keep it in your mind. No need to save anywhere. It's a superior nun. Prioress. And her name is Madam Eglantine. This you have to keep it in mind. Madam Eglantine. Her name is Madam Eglantine. And prioress, Chaucer presents, really Chaucer, while describing this character, really portrays the each character into the reader's mind. And prioress, he tells that she is very modest and she has a good manners in her dines. Means what? She used to keep a good dining manners. She never used to make any kinds of sound while taking her meals. Then, moreover, she is very modest. She wears well rich clothes. Then she is having a brooch on her chest, and something is written in that. What is that? Love conquers all. Love conquers all. This is written in her brooch. Moreover, she carries a grocery always in her hand. This is prioress. Now next one, the second nun. Second nun. Chaucer has not given any physical description about our second nun. But second nun, she always denounces laziness and always talks about virginity. And only this much thing is portrayed in second nun. So this much is today's topic. That is, first one is was knight, then came squire, then knight's yeoman, then prioress, and second nun. So today I'll be winding up with these five characters, means the pilgrims. Among the 29, I have told about the five. Okay, so rest pilgrims I'll be telling and I'll be describing in my next video. So what you have to do is you have to keep watching my next video. Dear students and dear friends, what you have to do is you have to support me by giving your valuable comments in your inbox. You have to give your likes and you have to give your shares, and also the most thing is you have to subscribe my channel. So once you have to subscribe my channel, then you have to click the bell button so that you will be getting all the notifications of all the videos that I'm uploading. So always keep in touch. See you in the next video.